In 2015, Bandai Namco released Dragon Ball Xenoverse, and it changed one person's life forever. To understand how Ryan Wade became Utmost Wicked, we need to go back to the beginning. Ryan Wade was born in 1986, Lexington, Kentucky. His parents were middle-class Americans. He had two sisters, Janice and Laurel. They will play a big role in his early life. Finding information on Ryan Wade wasn't so simple as it looked in the beginning. We spent months searching for his mother and we couldn't find anything. We had to contact private investigators to help us with our case. And after 4 months of hard work, we finally managed to contact her. Ryan Wade's mother was kind enough to let us interview her, but only on terms that we won't reveal her identity. So we had to alter her voice.
Ryan was the third child in our family. So his sisters were 8 and 12 years old by the time little Ryan reached 4. They would play with him as if he was some kind of doll, dressing him up with girly outfits. He didn't like that at all. But we couldn't do anything, we were at work. There was no one to protect him from his sisters. So he would close himself in his room and wait for us to come back from work. His sister really impacted his mental state. When he went preschool, he wouldn't communicate with other children because of the psychological trauma he received from his sisters.
But everything changed in 1992 when Ryan's parents took him to the arcades.
We thought taking Ryan to the arcades would cheer him up.
And it did. For the first time in his life, Ryan was happy.
It was a miracle. Our Ryan was so happy, I could not believe it. Every day he would beg us to take him to arcades, but we did not have time for it, so we made a decision to buy him Sega Genesis so he could play his favorite games like Mortal Kombat at home.
So what's blast processing do?
But it did not last for long.
At first, everything was just amazing. Ryan was happy, enjoying his life. But the more he played with his Sega Genesis, the more he would distance himself from the real world. He was living in his own fantasy world where he was some kind of superhero. We tried to explain to him that there is a difference between the real world and computer games, but he would not listen.
The situation reached the boiling point in 1996. Ryan's father has left their family.
Thomas left the family because he did not like how Ryan was growing up. He blamed me that I did not look after him, so he filed a divorce. Because of that, my little boy lost his appetite. He would eat once a day. I knew I had to do something or else my son will die. And to make his life happier, I bought him Nintendo 64.
Showtime! Fairy Fox 2, Rubber Froggy! I am leaving the park!
Nintendo 64.
Power up. Speed.
Bam! That decision saved Ryan's life, but at the same time it sucked him into a virtual world even more. In 2005, Microsoft revealed their next generation console, Xbox 360, with Xbox Live functionality, which allowed users to communicate with each other. That is when Ryan started building up his confidence by insulting other players, because he knew he could get away with it.
2005 was a weird year. When Ryan got his Xbox 360, he started showing his emotions. He would play against real people, and when he would lose a match, he would scream and punch walls. But after a month, something snapped in him. He started sending voice messages to other players, joking about their mothers, insulting them in various forms.
Well, you're gonna be posted on YouTube anyways for further humiliation, so it doesn't really fucking matter.
You're a piece of shit. You're my bitch forever. Piece of shit.
As one can imagine, this continued behavior on Xbox Live was deemed unacceptable by the standard set by the Xbox Live service terms conditions, and Ryan Wade failed to abide by the code of conduct. As a result, Ryan was permanently banned from Xbox Live. His mother had then decided that he was old enough and had saved up enough pocket money to purchase his first gaming PC in 2014.
It was pretty accurate.
The Tekken live action was fucking bad.
And they made a sequel. Where did they come from?
Yeah, but that's not American-made for American theaters.
It just, he has it on rerun or some shit. It's just fucking going.
Lost the rage quick because he was losing.
We lost him. Oh no, it's just the lag.
And he's actually
literally could not do anything.
No.
You literally could not do anything during that because it fucking...
He probably does that a lot.
It's...
Where he charges the super, hits the lag switch, and then it just works.
By saying he did lag switch, he's seen that before.
Yeah.
Here he goes.
Holy shit!
I'm jumping up forward, though.
What a bitch!
Oh my god! Oh my god! That is unbelievable!
Yay! Yeah, yeah.
Your lag switch can't even win you a game, dude. 4,000 people feel nothing but shame.
Oh, lost connection!
Connected to opponent!
I killed him through his lag switch.
Wow.
There you go.
Due to the nature of Ryan Wade's dirty tactics and cheated playstyle, it didn't take long for the community to become known to the presence of an entity titled Troll Sagat, the lag-switching spammer who hacked his tournament score and faked his identity.
Oh, it's Troll Sagat! I joined his lobby! Let's fuck him up again!
Oh my god, it's this guy! It's this guy! It's the Rage Quitter! We gotta beat him again! We actually gotta beat him again! It's the Rage Quitter, guys. We gotta beat him again.
Look, if you're gonna be a fucker to me, then PTSD, my Sagat PTSD is gonna start kicking in. I hate this guy already. No. Now, why do I have this feeling I'm being horribly trolled?
Hey, it's Troll Sagat! Let's join Troll Sagat's lobby. Guys, I am joining Troll Sagat's lobby. Let everybody witness his rage quit. Shall we? Watch this motherfucker rage quit. There it is! Troll Sagat fucking exposed! Stay free, you motherfucker!
Cheater, asshole, lowlife, motherfucker. Oh, zero everything fucking real. Suck my dick, dude. You're a cheating asshole. I know I'm a fucking master compared to you, bro. Fuck off. This is some booster account, asshole. Yeah. Random fucking booster account. Leg switching booster fucking
you. Hey, listen. That scumbag asshole, that fake, you know, A plus one Sagat morons running around out here being a douche and doing his thing. Just so you know, he keeps changing his name. He has like no less than 5 profiles that he's using to do this. I've been having to check everybody's personal profile before fighting them to weed them out, and I actually still got caught with this scumbag. I want to physically injure this person.
Cheaters! Nothing but cheaters!
Who is this asshole? No, I need to know who this is. It's probably Troll Sagat with this fucking garbage, whatever the fuck. He's already leg switched, man. That was 20 minutes late. Yeah, I had nobody. Uh-huh, of course. Yeah, this is normal. Yeah. No.
Trollsagot again? Are you fucking kidding me? It's Trollsagot again. This motherfucker is not.
No, I'm leaving. I'm not gonna play this shit. Fuck you, cheating piece of garbage! Fuck you, dude. Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you with your fake ass fucking points.
2015. To start things off in 2015, let's begin at the point in time right before Liquid Snake SSJ4 met Ryan Wade, and build up on the events that unfolded from there onwards. Back in 2015, Ryan Wade was under the alias Newest Threat, and met Liquid Snake SSJ4 through Dragon Ball Xenoverse 1 when Liquid began to notice that a new threat had appeared in third place on the leaderboard. This was around the time when Liquid had only just transitioned from PlayStation 4 over to the PC platform and was relatively new to the whole Steam community. This is back before anybody knew who Newest Threat was. We had no idea how much of a threat he was at the time. Shortly after noticing this movement, Liquid had decided to send Newest Threat a friend request. Little did he know of what the result of a simple friend request would offer down the timeline over these past 3 years. Ever since Liquid and Newest Threat became connected on Steam, shit hit the fan at full blast. There was never a moment between the both of them where things were calm collected. Here is a quote from Liquid himself back in 2015. That sly prick cannot be trusted. All he does is lie, cry and deny everything. All he'd do when we first met was join my session on his fake alternate Steam profiles and hack his game so that he obtained God mode and infinite key and stamina. Then he'd recall these matches with me whenever I fought him back with mods of my own. In fact, the only reason I ever downloaded a Xenoverse 1 mods were because of Ryan Wade to begin with. He introduced me to cheat engine and speed hack. All he'd ever do is try to frame me as a hacker and make out that he's a legitimate player. Well, that's bullshit and everything that comes out of his mouth is dog shit. I used to be a modding script kid at the very beginning, but it didn't last long. It was only due to the PC hype and the fact it's available and possible on a PC to mod games at such a high capacity. 2016. The highlights of this year are as follows. Newest Threat gets banned on his main Steam profile. Due to this, he migrates to another one of his alternate profiles and attempts to pass it off as if he never got banned to begin with. He discards his old profile and abandons it in the hope that nobody else will ever notice. During this migration to a new Steam profile, Newest Threat comes up with the idea that he could create more fake alternate Steam profiles and intentionally vac-ban them for the sake of impersonating other innocent players who he dislikes just so that he can make an attempt at ruining their reputation as legitimate Xenoverse players. He would also create fake videos and chat logs with the help of his friend Ryker. No one was safe at that time. Wicked was releasing videos every day exposing legit players in hacking and lag switching. After the release of Xenoverse 2, Wicked hacked World Tournament and got first place in the leaderboards. But he made a huge mistake by talking to Velek, who recorded Utmost Wicked in admitting of hacking the leaderboards.
Dude, what place are you in your region's tournament right now? Let's get you up to first place in like three battles. Wanna do that? Just don't tell anybody I told you this, and if they fucking ask you about how you got your points, you just tell them you got really fucking good. Exactly, you know? I found out about that before he did. He creates like mods, like character mods and shit, and he learns about that from the Xenoverse mod website. He learns about tutorials from there to how to do it. But I found out about the number hacking before he did. That's why he was like so pissed off that I got first place in the TP ranks. And he was just like, we gotta find a way to fuck up Most Wicked up. And he was talking to you, he was like, so how many points you get, man? You're like, 40. And he's like, oh, damn. Because he's trying to figure it out. He figured it out too late, though. He had to take the next week, so he figured it out. It took him a week to figure out what I figured out in the first minute. Yeah, I like that. I fucking love that, dude. I'm just like, you know, you're good at creating shit, but logic and common sense just flies out the window in your mind, doesn't it? Okay, here's the thing. You know how to scan for numbers of cheaters, right?
Following the route of his freakishly destructive ways as a cheat engine script kid, Utmost Wicked soon found himself bound by fate in a cold, dark future that awaited him for his evil wrongdoing to other innocent players. The next event taking place here is in December 2016, when Wicked was detected by VAC for cheating in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2 with aimbot. Due to Utmost Wicked still continuing to impersonate innocent players and frame them on Xenoverse 2 for no reason other than the fact that they beat him fairly, Wicked Black made his first appearance with the aim of attempting to put Utmost Wicked in his place to deliver justice where it was deserved. However, due to unfortunate circumstances, Wicked Black's inexperience and lack of skill due to stealing Utmost Wicked's body in another alternate universe, he was unable to tap into the full potential that Utmost Wicked had to offer, even though it wasn't that much anyway. Wicked Black was unable to prevent Utmost Wicked from continuing to be a freak of nature. He could not be stopped. He would continue and keep going on to the point where Utmost Wicked eventually owned over 50 alternate fake Steam profiles. 2017. During this period, newest threat was back on a new unbanned profile and kept up with his methodical means of attack on the innocent Xenoverse community. What Utmost Wicked didn't anticipate down the line of 2017 was that the girl he had fallen in love with over the internet was going to block and remove him soon over the fact he was overly obsessive about her and too controlling. He tried to manipulate her all too often, all the while Utmost Wicked's reputation was beginning to become clear to the Xenoverse 2 community as everybody began to comprehend the full truth of Utmost Wicked's false victim-shaming lifestyle and had stopped taking Wicked seriously. Ryan Wade and Liquid's feud would continue into present day 2018 for the reason being that Utmost Wicked still had not decided to give up. Both of them continued to fight and protest each other as being the victim. Due to Utmost Wicked's previous history of attempting to impersonate other Dragon Ball Xenoverse players over losing against them, Utmost Wicked had ended up stockpiling a very high number of alternate VAC banned profiles over the years, and Steam were beginning to take notice towards this as a result of Liquid Snake's reports to Steam detailing the events of what Wicked had been up to on their platform. As we get closer to the end of 2018, Utmost Wicked still had not learned his lesson. He was still the fearsome Wicked Reign of Terror. Nobody could stop him. Steam couldn't stop him. Whenever they tried, he just got even angrier and the tears kept coming. As we've said before, nobody could stop those tears. We thought all hope was lost. Until. The day is the 11th of November and Utmost Wicked had uploaded a 10-minute long Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 Wing compilation against Liquid Snake, titled Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2. Having trouble dosing me, Liquid? This was a huge mistake on Wicked's part. Steam had enough. Wicked didn't seem to stop or learn from his past ordeals from getting banned repeatedly in his prior Steam history, so it happened again. Utmost Wicked had been making more false claims about Liquid, yet again saying that Liquid was attempting to dose attack him through Xenoverse 2's lobby by trying to obtain Wicked's zip address. And as we all know by now, Utmost Wicked is definitely full of dog shit. So Steam weren't having any of it, and Liquid decided to report Utmost Wicked one more time to alert Steam of not only what had happened between them as of recently, but also what he did a few days before when he was impersonating one of Liquid's friends called Yamal Kent, as known as Ot7 during this demonstration. Prior to Liquid reporting Ryan Wade on the 11th of November, Utmost Wicked had created a fake impersonated profile of Ot7 and then proceeded to formulate a fake chat log of this user so that Wicked could attempt to frame Yamal Kent and Liquid Snake at the same time by saying that the both of them tried to impersonate Utmost Wicked. Steam saw this video, instantly knew what Wicked was up to again with his fake alternate profiles, and as further action towards Utmost Wicked, Steam had decided to ban Utmost Wicked's most recent profile, Newest Threat. It is now nearing the end of 2018, and everybody here at Project Infamous believe that Ryan Wade has no more money left due to the fact he had spent over $1,000 just for the sake of rebuilding each main Steam profile Wicked was ever banned from. So now Wicked is currently left without a main Steam profile to go back to, and this has caused Utmost Wicked a great deal of stress. Ryan Wade has been so stressed out over the time span of these past 3 years that he has been rapidly aging, and he is now becoming gray.
Someone on the outside is sending him commands.
Jam the signal! Jam the signal! Goddamn retorts!
Working on it.
I think that you fucking do it.
Look at this knife. Imagine me sticking it into your gut. Again. Sorry, but that won't work this time. Ha
At most, Wicked pulled the unexpected. Nobody could have assumed this twisted turn of events. Nobody anticipated this end result. Nobody realized just how daunting and frightening newest threat could be up until now. It came as a shock to us all that we realized in horror that he had been resurrected to his former glory. Truly a nightmare to behold. He had been revived and he was back, eager to stir shit up and destroy anybody in his path. Newest threat was once again a fearsome devil not to be underestimated. Liquid Snake had sustained quite a lot of damage at this point, and he was almost unable to prevent Newest Threat from launching his nuclear attack on the Dragon Ball Xenoverse community. As of yet, Newest Threat holds the Dragon Ball Xenoverse 2 community a hostage of his will, and the only thing capable of neutralizing Newest Threat now is if another one of his virtual online girlfriends were to remove and block him. We don't know when this day will come, but we await to see what the future has in store for us. Ryan Wade is a nice person. He is just troubled, overly paranoid, defensive. From my analysis of everything under speculation so far, I'd like to conclude that Ryan Wade should definitely try to avoid doing anything that will get him banned on Steam in the future, such as making more fake alternate Steam profiles to impersonate other players just because he lost a legitimate game against them on Dragon Ball Xenoverse. And that it would be best if Ryan stopped stalking every single female on Steam who shows him even the smallest ounce of attention. And that nobody is to blame but Ryan Wade himself for all of the events that have transpired to this date. Take the right path, utmost wicked. You can be Dexter without having to be a dick. Happy birthday, Ryan Wade. From all of us here at Project Infamous.